like I'm working towards completing something. Completing something for showcase, completing something to go out, like the film festivals to, and work on stuff, right? And all that time and money invested, it's like, it just, it's not gonna be done. It's like I can't finish the film without the remaining shots, right?
Yeah.
It'll be incomplete. So it's like, why, like, I think the demotivating factor is like, why put all this effort into something? It's like, you're kind of like, you can't finish.
Yeah.
Right? Until you can finish it, right? Until you can have the puzzle pieces, right? So that's demotivating. I'm thinking about, like, polishing older projects instead. Excuse me. To get them ready for festivals instead. But still, like, I don't know. It's just...
Yeah, it's just like, you have only how, like, you have, you just have 10%. And now you cannot finish it.
Yeah. But it's like the thing about those 10% is they're 10% that's kind of essential because it like links the film together.
Yeah.
And like, it also is like the pen, like I told you, I lost footage. The pen ultimate, sequence of the film, scene of the film is missing coverage of the character getting their monologue because it got lost because my DIT didn't do the job properly, right? So I can't even end the film. It's like I have everything up and then like the film, like the climax of the film happens and then the falling action afterwards is like gone. So it's really frustrating. And I feel like I keep just like sitting against doors all day and it's like bothering me. In the sense of like, I feel like I'm being lazy. Like I feel like I can't do anything.
So I'm
using it to try to like play video games that I haven't played in a while. Like, oh, I got this game, I never played it, right? But now I'm like sitting here like playing video games and I feel bad. I don't feel like, it's like I'm killing time, but like, it's like, it's all I'm doing, right? I don't feel, it reminds me of when I like didn't go to school for a while and I felt like my life wasn't going anywhere, right? I feel like I haven't felt that way in like forever. And like I feel like I'm sitting here and like I'm spinning my wheels and it sucks. But everybody feels that way. Everything's on hold. So it's like everybody is like that.
Yeah. But one more question is that as you can see, many Asian people really has everything. And the American and other American and other races and other
cultures, right?
And cultures and races, they also think that they intend not to wear masks.
Yeah.
What do you think? Do you have any idea or how do you think?
Yeah, it's definitely like a thing that I've noticed that Asian people do a lot that definitely never happens over here, like ever. I always see people from China or Japan or Korea like wear the mask and do things, right? It's never been a thing. I don't know why. I think the theory I thought it was that, because I originally saw them in Japan, from Japan, and I thought it was a situation where Japanese business life is so rough, where they're like, we don't care if you're sick, you have to come to work.
Yeah.
And so they're like, okay, well, if I have to come to work, I don't want to get people sick, so they wear the mask, right?
Yeah.
So they have to, right? That's what I thought it was, but clearly it's something that crosses like over into all Asian cultures. I'm not sure. I think it's just not something, I just don't know. Just not something people do. And when people wear it, because it's so odd, when people wear the mask, and you see that, people think there's something really wrong, right? That in America, right? Because you probably know there were like racist attacks against like Asian people, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
And part of that is like, you don't usually see that, right? So, and somebody who's like ignorant or doesn't understand, like sees it, they're like, that's something's really wrong with that person or else they wouldn't be wearing a mask, right? And then they do stupid stuff. Like, so I'm not sure. I think like, that's just the best explanation I can give.
Why? 看现在的状况，就是大家都在买，大家都要戴的，然后最后就是医院没用嘛。其实医院是最需要的嘛。
对。
所以现在变成是大家开始收集口罩，然后捐给医院嘛。
嗯。
因为大家当初其实买了很多，就不是说亚洲人，或者我觉得也有很多美国人，或许他们买了很多。
嗯。
现在变成是要捐回去给医院。我觉得当初或许就是在当下，大家其实看到是大家是恐慌的，因为大家好像说什么，就是说。那就流传说吃什么比较有用啊，戴口罩就可以预防啊，你不出去就可以预防，所以大家就开始跟从这些东西，然后大家就开始收了很多口罩。
嗯，
我是觉得是说，他说就是健康就不戴口罩，我是一半认同啊。当然你去人多的地方，因为你也不知道谁健康谁不健康，所以其实我们的做法都是你去人多的地方，我管他健不健康，我还是会戴，但走在路上，我们就比较不会说一定要非戴不可，对。
有没有可能就是有人说这是文化原因，就是东亚人就是平时也是戴口罩可能要比美国人可能要多一些。
对，有点文化方面的原因吧。
嗯。
就在国内戴口罩还挺经常见的。
对。
而且还有那种布口罩。
对。
对，就不是那种医用口罩，布口罩。
对，防冻的。
有时候防冻，有时候空气污染啊之类的。
嗯嗯。
有的是耍帅啊，你看有些明星戴着口罩，怕别人认出他来。
对。
还有就是，亚洲最近经过 SARS， 还有那些
MERS，
就是可能经历了这么多，然后慢慢大家对这个越来越接受，越来越敏感了吧？
嗯。
对，需要戴。然后美国这边可能没有经过 SARS 那么严重的。这种流行传染病，所以
对，
而且说实在，我觉得那是一个点。另外一点，我觉得就是，其实美国人与人之间距离很远吧？
对，是。
像国内的话，就其实因为不几乎都是大城市，
对
对，
就算在比较乡下的地方，还是人一样还是很多。
对呀、啊。
所以唯一的方法就是不戴口，就是戴口罩。
嗯。
那美国人跟人那么远，除非你，所以你常常看到美国人就是在学校一上课，在学校上课，基本上只要一个学生得了，全部就得了。其实我觉得就像亚芬讲，就是整个文化习俗上的部分，就是没有经过那一次，然后平时也不太会遇到这种问题，所以就会觉得无所谓。
因为美国人认为是你戴口罩一定是有病，可能他们就这么认为。所以说。我所以说，当我们戴口罩的时候，很多人美国人会觉得，哇，你是不是有病啊？有病你怎么还来出来？
对啊，而且他们这边文化就是，你有病了就待在家里，不要出来。
对呀、
啊。但他看到你戴口罩，就觉得你有病，而且你还往外面跑。
对、
啊。你就不考虑别人的感受，
啊，
不考虑别人的安全。
我们亚洲人不太一样吧？亚洲人就算得病，就你没有病到。不能走，不能动，不能怎么样子的话，只要能下床，我们基本上都还是会出
去
的。
去上班，
对
吧？对
啊，我们的个性就是这个样子嘛。
对啊，像他们这里，我觉得这点很好啊，就是平常就算你得一个感冒，你就待在家嘛，不要出来。我觉得这样挺好的，也不会传给同事啊、同学。
他们比较多是这个样子，就会直接说我不来，就是我感冒怎么样？其实你看他可能表面上根本。没什么事，就是只是个鼻塞、喉咙不舒服而已，但是他们就不出现。对啊。
现在美国医院还蛮缺这个口罩的，对，缺口还蛮大。
其实是医院在缺，我觉得其实一般小诊所或什么，其实那应该还好。医院的话是重，我觉得是跟那些重症他们在，就是做临床重症的，其实他们比较会有缺这方面的东西。像今天他们要必须跟病人近距离的接触嘛？
对呀、
啊，对啊。
他们可能同时也是考虑到，将来如果有一波病人高峰的话，他们要做储备，所以他们现在肯定是有的。比如今天他们肯定是有口罩用的，但是明天呢、后天呢，或者说如果有越来越多病人进来怎么办？他们需要更多的这些 PPE， 所以他们需要为这些做准备。
对。
就像库莫他开会的时候一直在说，纽约州需要30000个呼吸机。
对呀、
啊。但是现在他不需要这么多，但是他要为将来
高峰
到来的那一波高峰做准备，所以现在在医院 扩加床位啊，然后来买更多的呼吸机啊，都是为这个做准备的。对，要他们要看的长远一些。
其实我觉得这是好的了，因为就开始有做准备了，比起就是大概一两个月，就是比起一个月前事情刚发生的时候，我觉得好很多，因为一开始发生的时候，其实就是他们 describe 的其实就是一个 crazy 的一件事情，但我觉得没有，就是没有重视，然后现在就比较有，就是有在未雨绸缪的感觉啦，所以我觉得是好的，
哦，其实我们大学生上网课还能好一些，可能小孩子上网课就更困难，对吧？
对，小孩子的问题更多的是，我也不知道，家长们要去，小孩子在家，家长肯定要去看他们，
好像是，
对，所以家长们做事情也会效率低，就是在网上看到一个图片说 work from home， 就看到父母都坐在桌子，父母坐在桌子两边，然后孩子们被用胶带固定在地上。
我们老师就说他们现在在家感觉时间变多了，但是感觉事情好像也变多了。
对，